Hey guys, welcome back to the Second Time Lucky Mining channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about helium mining. More specifically, my 4-week anniversary doing helium mining. In the video, we're going to discuss my history. So obviously 4 weeks worth of history. We're going to talk about the issues that I've experienced in those 4 weeks and how I've overcome that. We're going to talk about the equipment, so antennas or cables that I've bought in the last 4 weeks. And specifically, what have I tested and what's the outcome of that testing? We're going to talk about my earnings or my lack of earnings. And then, you know, do I think it's worth it in 2022? Starting with the history, for those of you that might not have watched my video, I'll leave a link in the video description and then I'll put a card on top here in case you want to click through it. But a short recap is I bought a Bobcat 300 miner and then I realized that I'm not gonna get it anytime soon. So I bought a brand new Sensecap M1 miner from a scalper on the 8th of January. So it's literally 4 weeks ago. And that's sort of how I started mining. So looking at the issues that I've experienced, I think it's good because anybody that's new to helium mining, you'll probably experience the same thing. And you know, this is good for managing expectations. So what can you expect and sort of how do you overcome it? So what happened for me, starting off with the first issues, is syncing the blockchain. So luckily the Sensecap M1 was actually quite good in syncing the blockchain. So it took about 1 or 2 days, I think 2 days max, syncing the blockchain. So it's a lot better than some of the other devices out there that I hear takes a week to sync. So that was actually quite good. However, the next issue that I experienced was the relay issue. And for me, and I think that will probably be the case for most people, you know, I didn't know that you needed to open up or do some port forwarding, but I experienced the relay issue. And for that, you really need to either speak to your ISP to get a static IP, and you need to go and open some ports in the router. For me, however, you know, that wasn't supported by the 5G internet that I had at home. So I had to get, you know, a fiber connection installed, which took another week. So that sort of, you know, sucked for me because I didn't earn a lot in that time period. So the relay issue is real. You just need to make sure that, number one, you can port forward and then your router supports those type of functions. There's lots of videos also on the internet to help you with that. I might, you know, do a quick one for people that's got an ASUS router because it will be router specific. So looking at all of the equipment that I've bought and what have I tested so far. So if you've watched that first video that I had, I actually got this antenna. So this is an outdoor antenna. It's a 6 dBi McGill antenna. So the scalper sold it to me when I picked up the miner. So I've tried and tested this. I obviously tested the stock standard antenna that comes with the helium miner. So that's obviously the first one that I had, which wasn't great, but in the defense of the miner, or the stock standard antenna that comes with the miner, is I had lots of relay issues at that time. So I don't think, you know, the bad earnings necessarily is attributed to the antenna that comes with the Sensecap M1. But I did test this antenna, this McGill antenna, as soon as my relay issues were fixed. Unfortunately, at the time, I only had a long cable that had this connection here at the bottom. So I'll see if I can... it zooms. So I had a 40-foot cable, so it was not great, to be honest, or it wasn't what I expected, unfortunately. So this antenna wasn't really great. I then went and ordered a 5.8 dBi internal antenna, so that's what's running at the moment. So we can talk about my earnings specifically around that. So I'll go to the computer and show you guys sort of what that looks like. And I'll shortly show you the video around that. But I've got the 5.8 dBi internal antenna. I then also ordered a lot of other antennas. So I think I've got my list here. So if I just quickly talk you through all of the antennas that I have. So first off, I've got this one, the 6 dBi one that I've talked about. I've got the 5.8 internal or indoor antenna, and I'll show it to you upstairs. Then I've ordered another indoor 8 dBi antenna, so I'm still waiting for that, so I expected to get it the end of the month. I then have a 3 dBi internal antenna that I ordered, and then another 3 dBi indoor slash outdoor antenna. So I've got 6 antennas, including the standard antenna that I have, that I want to test. I ordered, like normal for me, I ordered the wrong cables at the beginning, but I've now managed to find a couple of cables. So I've got a 3 meter, or I think it's 10 foot, LMR 400 cable. So this is what this one is. So you can see it's got the correct connector right there, and then it's got the connector that needs to go into the Helium hotspot. So so that's quite good. So this is 3 meters, and then I've got a shorter one. So I think this is 3 foot. So same thing, it's got the correct connector for these big antennas. Unfortunately, it doesn't have, I don't think it's got the correct connector on the other side, but I've got a little adapter that can swap it around. I also have a couple of shorter cables that I've got on order with some of these antennas. So the idea is that I am going to go and test all of these 6 different antennas, one every week with a different cable combination, just to figure out sort of what works best. Ultimately, you know, for me, you want to keep, or at least what I understand is you want to keep the cable as short as possible. And depending on your topography or what does your area look like, you know, some antennas might be better or worse depending on which hotspots do you need to go and hit. So that's sort of why I've got, you know, 6 antennas to test, you know, ultimately which one works best for where I am at the moment. Earnings wise, it really hasn't been great. So as I mentioned, the first couple of, or at least the first week or two, the earnings has been next to nothing. You know, over the 30 days or the 30 day average, again, I've only been, it's only been 4 weeks, so it's technically 28 days, but you know, the statistics that I have over 30 days, it's, I've mined 1.228 helium, so that's about $36 worth. So I'm very far away from breaking even with my input cost, especially if you count all these antennas that I've bought. And then on the last week, so using the current setup, and again, I'll show you that video just now, 0.48, so almost a half a helium in the last 7 days. So as you can see, it's been better towards the latter part, so since I fixed all of my issues. On top of that, something to note also though is, especially if you watch other people's YouTube videos, you know, there's probably a lot of people that earn a lot more, but there's also been some changes, or recent changes, to the Helium network. So there's been changes that I think they reduced the amount of witnesses or beacons to get witnesses or something like that. So I'll leave a link to a video explaining that. But I think on the 28th of January, they made some changes to help the Helium network survive a little bit better. There was lots of syncing issues that people reported and all sorts of things like that. So they, the Helium community and foundation is working to sort out all of those issues, and as a result of that, they've reduced the amount of witnesses or beacons that goes out for witnesses. So ultimately, you will be earning less compared to what you know, potentially you see on the internet what other people have been earning. So there has been fundamental changes to the network.
All right, so here we are upstairs on the second floor. So you can see the gaming computer, and right at the back is where I've got the Sensecap M1, and there you can see the cable trickling all the way to the 5.8 dBi antenna that's in the window there. I think the cable is 3 meters long, so I think that's about 10 foot. So that's the current setup that I have, and this is sort of primarily where I will be testing the different antennas. This is a rented place, so I can't really do a lot in terms of drilling or anything like that, unfortunately.
That's it for this one, guys. If you've liked the video, please like it and maybe consider subscribing. If you didn't, please specify in the comments what you would like me to change. On top of that, I'd love to hear which antennas and cables you guys are using. So if you can please specify in the comments. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.